Welcome everyone. Today I'll show you how to write C program of computing n factorial using for loop. We can also do it by do while loop or while loop. But let me first tell you it using for loop. So this is a header file that we always declare in the beginning of the program, hash include stdio.h. Then this is the body of main function. We first of all declare the variables that we are going to use here. So we are going to use here the variable I, and we need a number to compute the factorial n of that number. So let that number is denoted by n. Obviously the number is integer, so we write it here. And we need one more variable to store the factorial of that number. So we let that variable is say fact. Okay. Now we first of all ask the user the value of n. For that we have to print a message on the screen. Enter the value of n. Okay. Now we there is a mistake here. It is printf. Now we receive that value by scanf command. We use %d here because n is integer. And ampersand n to store the value of n at the address of n. Now we start for loop here. The format of for is, there are three conditions. One is initialization. So we use I for that. I is equal to 1, initialization. Second is condition to check, means we have to compute the factorial n up to n times starting from 1. And here we use increment condition. Now we put the braces here because there is if there is one single statement after for loop, you need not to put the braces here. But if there are multiple statements after for loop, we have to put braces. So I think we need braces here. So we first of all initialize the value of fact as say 1. Okay. Otherwise, it will take any garbage value. So we write here, new value of fact is old value of fact multiplied with I. Now what will happen here is, new value of fact will be 1 into 1 because I is initialized as 1. So new value of fact is 1. Now next is, again it will come to this condition, I is less than equal to 1. Before entering into the for loop, first it will initialize the value of I as 1, then it will check this condition. Suppose you enter the value of n as 5, so 1 is less than equal to 5, so it will enter inside the loop. Then it will come here. It will not go here. It will come here. This will execute it first. I is equal to 1. Then the condition will be checked. Then this statement will be executed. After execution of this statement, it will come at the third condition, which is the increment condition. That is, the value of I has been increased to 2. I is equal to I plus 1. I plus plus means I is equal to I plus 1, means आई की जो प्रीवियस वैल्यू थी उसमें वन ऐड हो जाएगा, सो न्यू वैल्यू ऑफ आई विल बी टू नाउ. तो मेमोरी में वन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय टू. वंस दिस इज इंक्रीमेंटेड अगेन द कंडीशन विल बी चेक्ड, टू इज लेस देन एन, एन इज फाइव इफ सपोज, तो टू इज लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव, सो इट इज ट्रू, सो इट विल कम्स हियर. So new value of fact will be old value of fact, which is 1 star 2, that is 2. So 2 will be assigned to fact. Then it will increment the value of I as say 3. It will check the condition 3 is less than equal to 5, which is true. It comes here. So new value of fact will be old value of fact, which is 2 star 3. So 2 star 3 is 6. 6 will assign to fact. Again, this will increment I, the value of I has been incremented. So the value of I will be now 4. 4 is less than equal to 5. So 4 will be multiplied to the old value of fact, which is 6. So new value of fact will be 24. Now next value of I will be 5. 5 is less than equal to 5, true, it will come here. So 24 multiplied by 5 is 120, is assigned to fact. It will again increase the value of I as 6, but 6 is not less than equal to 5, so it will comes out of the loop. ये जो कंडीशन है आई इज इक्वल टू वन केवल एक बार एग्जीक्यूट होती है, उसके बाद ये कंडीशन, ये स्टेटमेंट और ये कंडीशन, ये इन तीनों में एक सर्कल बन जाता है, यही तीनों एग्जीक्यूट होती हैं इनसाइड द फॉर लूप. तो फैक्ट हमारा कैलकुलेटेड है, हमें ब्रैकेट्स की जरूरत नहीं है क्योंकि देयर इज ओनली वन स्टेटमेंट वी नीड आफ्टर फॉर लूप. नाउ वी प्रिंट, we use printf command to print the value of factorial. So we print the message, the value of factorial n is %d. And %d will be replaced by fact. We can write here also value of factorial. N की जगह आप लिख सकते हो %d, and you can put n first and then fact. So this %d will be replaced by n, and this %d will be replaced by fact. तो स्क्रीन पर ऐसे लिखा हुआ आएगा, the value of factorial 5 is 120. Okay. So now let's run the program. Press this button on your screen. You can see the messages here. Enter the value of n. So let me enter 5. Press enter. You can see the value. The value of factorial 5 is 120. Let's run it again. Let's enter say 6. Press enter. So it's 720. Okay, it's correct. Let's run it again. Let me enter 0. The value of factorial 0 is 1. Okay. Because we have initialized fact by 1. So it will not go inside this for loop, but it will print this message. So the answer is correct. Okay. You can put a condition of a negative number also. If you can check if value of n is negative, then you can print the message that the value of n is wrong. Put a positive integer, or you can write the message here, enter the positive, enters positive integer, some positive integer to calculate the factorial n. Okay. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you understand the program of computing the factorial n. In my next video, I will tell you how to write this program using while loop. We can also write this program using while loop. Okay, this is a for loop. Okay, thank you so much.